Welcome to PJ's Q&A section. Hello everyone, a lot of people asking me about the mesh and how the STL file can be used. There's some restriction in Rhino. I will say Rhino is not the best program for the mesh, although you can do a little bit editing. And what that means is if you have this mesh import to your Rhino file, it's hard to edit. Even though you say you want to turn on a control point, it is so much point right there, it's really hard to edit. So what we can do is a simple edit by just putting the logo on the top or things like that. For example, I have a text PJ right here as a poly surface. This is our nerve surface. And when we try to bowling this, for example, I'll just hit on bowling, it will tell me that it is not intersect. So what we need to do is we need to either turn this into the poly surface and the nerve surface, or we turn this into the mesh. As you can see, this is already have a lot of the surface right there. If we turn it into the poly surface, it's gonna be a huge file. So we will rather turn this into the mesh. So I'm just gonna mesh it pretty quick, and then you can preview for whatever that is. Let's make it more polygon, and then you will see something like this. Okay, so what we're gonna do here is if you go to the mesh toolbar, then you have this is you can do mesh bowling, you can do mesh bowling difference and things like that. So I'm going to pick up my poly surface and I'm just gonna hide it, and we're gonna have this is a mesh, this is all three are mesh, and we can bowling union using the mesh bowling union together. Still, this is a closed mesh. So with that saying, all three thing is closed mesh, then you can use the bowling tool. However, if I have something like this that I download from the website, and by the way, I download this free model from CG Trader, from the author is Quinton Pelling. If I pronounce this correct, he has a lot of like dog model, and this happened to be a free. I'm just downloading for the educational purpose, but I just want to show you where I get it. And then so with this, a lot of time when you have this kind of a mesh, they may not be a closed mesh. As you can see, this say an open mesh. Let's take a look on where it is broken. We're going to use analyze, and then you have the edge tool, and then you want to click on the object, and it will show, we can zoom in to see where the naked edges is. So it is right here. If you flip it over, and it's right there. So if it is not too complicated, we can use to fill the mesh hole by clicking on the edges. So that will fix that one. And then you're gonna come over here to use the same command to fix that. So there are only few spots need to fix, and that will be okay. We can still using this mesh, and then you can put it into your ring, whatever you wanted to do with it. However, if this is completely open mesh or is irregular shape, then it will be hard to fix, and I will suggest to use other program like ZBrush to fix it. And once you fix it, you can bring it back to the Rhino. So I hope that answers your questions. Can we import other mesh object for Rhino to use? Thank you for watching. I'll see you next.